In order to configure a generic user in shop floor, we need to go into factory track administration to the users file. We would create a user such as generic, which would be used as a generic login for workstations that are distributed around the shop floor. The intention is these are logged in to factory track all day and allow the individual employees to come in and enter their numbers, perform their tasks, and then log back out so that the next employee can log in. In order to support this, the generic user needs to have the factory track base and factory track console permission groups. It also needs to be licensed. So depending on whether it's on-premise or in the cloud, if it's in the cloud, it would need the factory track cloud license. Otherwise, it needs factory track base and factory track shop floor ELN. If we look at the factory track info tab, we'll see that we need to create this user as a type of user. We can either allow the user to change the clock or not, depending on your preferences. And the menu group ID associated with the user should be LN main. Next, we need to look at the employees. These are the people who are actually going to log into the shop floor module by means of the generic login. If we look at the employees, so typically these are all employees. They should all have the work group of LN sup. So here we have 300109, and as you see, there are no usernames associated with these. These are employees that are going to use the generic login to access the system. So each of the employees should have LN sup set up as the work group, should have the default order type. In this case, we've set them all to production order, and should have a default resource group or work center. This means that by default, all information displayed for this particular employee will be related to this work center, although if necessary, they can work in separate work centers as well.